Hi, this is Bill from the Maker's Guide, and recently one of our forum members asked how to complete a task in Vectric Aspire. They wanted to make a circle that had a tapered inner ring for a dust collection project they were doing. So I thought I'd do this video and show how I would go about doing it in Vectric Aspire using some of the tools that are available to model. So let's begin. I started with a work piece that was 12 by 12 and 3/4 inches thick, and I set those up under the job setup. So I went to the drawing tools, and I knew since the profile that he wanted was going to be roughly rectangular to start with as the base shape, I just at random drew a rectangle on the screen. And we won't worry about the specific size at the moment. If you wanted to, you could scale it to the appropriate size. So I started with that as the basis of my drawing. And then I knew there were a couple of round portions. So I grabbed a couple of circles and pulled those over there, and just, this is just a rough approximation of what he was trying to do. So I knew that the second circle was slightly smaller than the first. Okay, and that's a basic shape with those circles. I try and make sure that I can get them as close as possible using the move tools to the and you can see the cursor change when I intersect with the end of something. I know this circle is just a bit down, so I'm using the jog keys to move it up, get that kind of lined up, and I come over here with my trim tools, get rid of the bottom portion of that circle and the straight line portion. And I'm going to do the same thing on this circle. We're just going to check a little bit using the tools to make sure that we're gonna get a half a circle there. Okay, we're lined up. You can see the cursor changes to indicate that. Okay, so that's the basic shape. Now the inner part of the circle is going to be tapered down, and the quick way for me to do that tapering is to use the node editing tools. And I click on the rectangle with the node editing tool, and I grab this one endpoint here, and I just click on that, and then I hit the down arrow a couple times to drop it down. And I think I might be a little thick on this, so I'm just going to grab these two points by dragging a border around them, and then using the up arrow to just kind of thin it out a little bit. So once I'm satisfied with the basic look and feel of that, I can keep the node editing on, and I can use the D key, which will delete a span between them. And that's really all I need there. I can come back out, and now I need a circle. And I need a circle in the middle of the workpiece. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just drag one out, and we're going to specify in this case 10 inches. We'll hit apply. Okay, and I know because my cursor changed that I'm also in the center here. So let's make this one 6 inches. Okay, so there's a 6 inch opening in the middle of the circles. Okay. These are all the forms I'm going to need to complete this ringed circle. So what I do next is I deselect the circles, and I come over here to the modeling tools tab, and I click on that, and then I use the two rail sweep tool, and I select the two circles. Looks like I've got more than one circle there. I'm going to just close that for a second. Delete one of them. Okay. So, make sure we're only on layer one. Okay. So I select this one, and I select that one by holding down the shift key. Come back to the modeling tools. And I select two rail sweep. And it's going to use these two circles as the basis for the shape that we're about to create. And I want to use the two that I've selected, so I hit use selection. And you notice the arrows are going in the same direction, so everything is right there. So next I hit the cross section that I want to use, which is this, and I hit apply. Now before I do that, I'm going to hit the page up the screen so we can see what this is going to look like in 3D. And I hit apply. And Vectric Aspire goes out and it calculates what we're going to need. And if we look at what it created, it's that ring with a taper in the center. Now, in order to do anything with this, we would have to use some of the vectors that it created to create a 3D toolpath for that.